When Chiwoo was freaking out, I started to stress the freak out as well. Because I remember that a few episodes back, Hwan's mom wasn't as supportive of Hwan's feelings for Chiwoo. So I was really nervous about this encounter. But then when the woman came in and saying, "Be happy," I was smiling so hard. Give this woman a medal. She is the best mother out there. Before we get started, I just want to remind our viewers that if you like seeing more Yaoi content and would like to support this channel, please don't forget to smash that like button. Also, if you haven't done so, please subscribe to this channel and hit that notification bell. Feel free to message me in my social media at ZEALED FUJOSHI, which I'll be using to interact with viewers about more Yaoi content. If that's something that interests you, feel free to follow me at ZEALED FUJOSHI. Finally, this episode will contain explicit content and a lot of manhwa spoilers. With that in mind, please proceed with caution. You have been warned. Now, without further ado, let's jump into chapter 36 of Your Wish is My Command. So Hwan's mom deserves the most supportive parent award. She's such a great mom. She deserves all the good things this world has to offer. Away from her approving or disapproving them dating, the fact that she took in Chiwoo while she was already a single mother, taking care of her own child on her own, which is a super hard thing to do, but she's still freaking nice. The gesture she did is seriously one of the best things a woman can do for a lonely kid. And when she said that it broke her heart when she was stopped asking for things, I cried. After he heard people talking badly about him and Hwan's family, some people can be so evil and their words can hurt a kid forever. And that's exactly what happened to Chiwoo. Like, some silly gossip that he overheard when he was a kid stopped him from having a very happy childhood. But I am so glad that Hwan's mom is so supportive of Chiwoo and Hwan. I was also happy that her first concern was if it's even consensual between Chiwoo and Hwan. It shows that she cares so much and she just wants them to be happy together. She is so accepting and it's so refreshing to see in, you know, if we compare this to all of the boys love or Yaoi that we've been, you know, reviewing in this channel, this act is so new and so refreshing. I really wish all parents or people in general could be as supportive like this. She has become one of my favorite characters in just one chapter. I'm happy that Hwan's mom accepted their whole relationship. But to be honest with you, I still don't feel great. I don't know why. I'm happy that the mom is supportive and that, you know, everything that Chiwoo was afraid of, like them breaking up, doesn't have to happen anymore. Because let's be honest here, one of the reasons we're even reading this series is because, you know, we love the sexy things that happens between Chiwoo and Hwan, wink wink. But you know, I'm probably just overthinking this, but I can't shake off the feeling that Hwan is weird. I understand that he could be very possessive, and I really hope the best case scenario is he really is just very possessive. And you know, I just hope that it's not some toxic thing that I am probably overthinking. I don't know. It's just a gut feeling that has no hardcore evidence. So it's kind of hard for me to explain. But the best way for me to say what I'm feeling about Hwan right now is he really feels suspicious. With all of the like weird stares that he gives Chiwoo, and you know, like it's borderline psychotic, it really makes him really suspicious to me. But one thing that I can't really wrap my head around is, you know, they have so much childhood memories. So is all of these fabricated? We don't know. We have no freaking idea. There's no clue to it yet. But the only thing we know is that they are childhood friends, and there's the mom that can vouch for their relationship. So we have no freaking idea what's going on with Hwan, but he's really suspicious. Anyway, this was a very nice chapter, especially for coming out and admitting to a parent about, you know, sexuality and, you know, the person that they love. So, you know, for me, everything was great up until the photo at the very end. Like, why? Anyway, I hope you enjoyed today's episode. Please don't forget to follow my social media to be teased about some of the boys' love that I'm interested in. Feel free to leave me a message and converse with me in my Discord channel. I'd love to hear back from you. And please consider supporting the show by donating as little as 99 cents through www.sealedfujoshi.xyz. Also, don't forget to support the author. All the manga details can be found in the description below. Again, thank you so much and hope to see you next time.